everyone, and welcome back to Crafting Arts with Violet. I actually have she's my best friend, but she's going to be my student. Don't forget to add water.
I know.
Hence why it's called watercolour.
I know. Hey. So I wanted to get a bit more of a thicker.
The best way to do it is with water. I know it's hard. how am I going to share this? I wonder... Do you think it would be okay? I know it's got juice in it, but... Do you think that would work?
Pour it out the window.
I can't stand up.
Okay. We'll just share it. We'll just share that one.
Okay.
I'll put it here.
All right.
I don't trust us, but yeah, we're prone to spilling things, but I think that it's
okay.
All right.
Let's focus. Yeah. Now, we already did... Oh, I just dropped my phone. Oh, God. There we go. So, we already did this one. We finished it a little bit ago. We are now moving on to a sunset. Why won't this... What's wrong? Okay, I thought you messed the painting up or something. Okay, so now we are doing a sunset. This time we are not going to be using Aqualine at all. We are going to be using completely different brands.
How's this?
Very good. Go down all the way. I'm going to probably be using the Arteza brush pens and paints, mainly because I want to show off the blending and the colours. So we're going to start with the brush pens. The brush pens I think work best with this paper. We're going to be doing a red and orange and yellow and possibly a very soft green just at the bottom, well, top technically. Well, we could actually overlap and make a blue with blue and overlap making a green, which will go very nicely, which is what I did with the roses. I'm just going to quickly, because this is from Instagram, I'm going to send this to two people. So just bear with me for a moment. All right, I sent it. Let's begin. Now, I have not used these a lot. I only used the red and the yellow for a rose, which was this rose in the corner. I have not used it much more than that, so this will be more of an experiment than anything. So we're just going to turn this so you can see the bottom. Just start with a little red at the bottom. It's best if you have tape on the bottom of your painting so that it doesn't go over when you use water and go on to the next page. That is how I like to do it. I'm just gonna do what I think looks best. Welcome. I hope that this isn't as boring as I think it is. I know I keep talking a lot, but it's only because I want you to get the best out of this session.
It's very therapeutic.
Yeah, it is. It's very relaxing and very good for the mind, the heart, and the...
It's really intriguing because it makes you want to try.
Mm-hmm.
To do what she does. She's amazing.
It is very interesting how it affects people. Because my best friend, who is my student right now, she does not like to paint because she feels like she keeps failing and she's just not good. but right now she's actually trying, and it is really cool that she's giving it a go and she's trying to do something that she's never done before, and it makes me really proud. So we're just gonna keep going like this. I tend to leave the brush paints just a little bit. I don't want to go too far, like I don't want to do it immediately before the ink settles. I tend to leave it for a little bit, do the rest of the paint brushes, and then go back and add the water, because I feel like that's just what's best and it works well. Right then, now you just use the next shade of blue and go over it.
I learned two different colours.
That looks really nice. That looks like a mountain.
That's really intrigued by purple blue. I think it's purple blue. I think it might be slightly
colour blind.
Is this purple?
It's more blue. This song is very unique. I don't have the controller, so.
I feel really at peace with myself, and I've never felt like this.
I know. Painting is a very therapeutic way of dealing with stress, and it calms you.
What should I do now?
Now you do, like, do you want to do shading, or do you want to do trees?
Trees.
Right, next what you do is you get the brushy pen, which is this green one.
Yep.
Make sure you don't have too much water. Put it in the black, which is this one. Mm-hmm. Just dab it on. No, I mean like onto the page.
What should I do, like here?
You can do a stalk, or you can just dab it into a... There you go. Now you just dab the stalk.
Like this?
Yeah, make sure to make it span out, so from small to big all the way down. Yeah, and it's okay if you get it wrong at first, because you can always try again.
How's that?
That is really good. Fill that bit there, make it a bit longer at the top. So if I show you, just to give it that sort of triangle look. Make it like an isosceles triangle. You know the one that has two long sides? That's the way I do it. Welcome.
How's that?
Perfect. Everyone has a different way of ending up with a, well, not ending up with, but like, it's hard to explain. Basically, everyone has a different way of their paintings ending up. Oh, excuse the app right now. I mean, the advert app. Where did that come from?
Okay, can I do it again, or?
You do a bunch of trees.
Okay.
Like that.
This is one, which one's the black? This one?
Yeah. If you ever need to know what colour it is, look at this.
Okay.
Alright. So, as you can see here, I've gone from pretty much a rainbow. Now we're just going to use the water brush, and we're just going to start adding the colour. What we want to do is we want to go in circular motion down here, just edge it on, give it a little, yeah, we just want to go in circular motion. Don't want to go over the orange too much, just enough that it can see the colour, and as you can see, it blends so well on this paper, unlike the book that I showed you earlier. On YouTube, you'll have to go to my Instagram, snowxrose1235, to have a look on my story and have a look at the live. It'll probably be gone by the time you look at it though, so this basically works on very specific paper, and it is very beautiful on this one. It doesn't work on all paper, it only works on very specific paper. I tend to use this for water brushes because it is the only way it works, really. I'm gonna try and get the red to blend with the orange. Just go over it, get rid of the line, and just keep going. Just make it really nice. If it goes over the yellow, that's okay, because we want to make sure that it's really good. It blends really well. And it's very relaxing and calming for you. You don't feel the need to like get it perfect, which is really good when you don't.
Yeah.
Especially when people are perfectionists, they can tend to think that it's wrong, that the way they're doing it, mm-hmm. when it's really not. It's just the way they see it. Like, I know you tend to always think that your painting is really bad. Mm-hmm. But how do you feel right now?
Good, it's going well.
Mm-hmm. So, let's have a little look. So this is how it's turned out so far. Thank you. This is actually my first time using Arteza brush pens properly, because I've been like, I used it for small things, but I never used it for big things. I should have really honestly used the yellow over the red like I did with the rose, but I didn't. But that's okay, it's all like experiments right now. So it's not terrible, it's just not the way I wanted it really, but that's okay. I can always fix it after the video.
Hey, you just said about perfection,
being so easy to perfect. I know, not perfect it like make it absolutely amazing, but I mean like perfect it as in like add details to myself.
Have this.
That's really good. Right then, we want to go on to the bluey green now. Just want to go over, just make it meet basically, so that when we add water next, it will just sort of blend. I'm not gonna lie, I've never blended greens or blues or yellows and oranges with Arteza brushes, because I literally just started using these like right now, so they are a bit rough edged, but they are really beautiful and really colourful. I think the more water you add, possibly the better, because it gets rid of all these rough sort of edges.
Okay, I'm happy with this.
As long as you're happy, that's good. I think maybe I should have really left out the blue, because I feel like the blue has dominated it all. And now I can't really get the red and orange to dominate it. First time, everything's trial and error right now. So I'm trying to make this travel down a bit, just so that I can get a bit of colour back into the yellow's hands and then serve it back up.
Oh, I have a good
Now I'm going to add a bit of orange on top of this just to even it out a bit, because I feel like it's very dominated by the green and blue and not enough orange and yellow. That is very good.
Okay, what now?
Well, now you do the ocean.
Okay, how should I?
Well, usually what I would do first is I would I'd do the trees in the water as well. So do the trees basically the exact same, pretty much. Where did I put the water brush? I literally just put it down. Oh my god, I keep losing things. Oh, it's right there. Oh, I did find the missing paintbrush that I put down earlier. It was in my cup of water. It was so small that I just couldn't find it. How typical. Alright, so I feel like this is pretty much done. I feel like maybe doing a bit more down here with the orange and the red. Just bringing the red up a bit, giving it a bit more power. But yeah, I feel like that is perfect. Well, not perfect, but it's the best that I feel like it should be at. I feel like it's at a level that I would want it to be at.
You're really good at making
water. Hmm? What do you mean? That's completely fine, because what you're going to do is you're going to put white over it.
Mm-hmm.
So don't worry if you mess up a little bit. And what I'm gonna do is I have to let this dry for a little bit because it is covered in water, so I have to let it dry for a bit. What I'm gonna do until then is I'm going to show you what my friend has done so far, if I may show them. This is her sky and this is her ocean. She's trying to basically make her own one. She is not very self-confident in her painting, which is, it's really okay, because I think it's gotten a lot better than the last time I saw it, and I feel like it's a lot better now that she's trying and she's inspired. And if I wasn't doing a tutorial right now, I honestly would be paying more attention to your work than mine, and it would come out a million times better. Well, not better, but like, you know.
Yeah.
You're really focused, aren't you?
Uh-huh.
Right then. Well, while I'm waiting for this to dry, I'm just gonna rub my finger over it a little bit. Dedication and ambition is the key. I agree with you on that.
Who said that?
You know who. I won't say names right now because I don't know, like, if I should. But you know what? You know who it is. Let's just say it's somebody you've been talking about a lot. Right then. So I'm just going to go off stream for a bit. And as soon as this is dry, I will come back on stream and I will basically continue. So this is what it looks like so far. Never be afraid to continue and don't let others judge. I agree. So I'm gonna let this dry and just go offline for a bit. I'm going to post this on YouTube now and I will be back. Okay. Oh, wrong button.